I wish to thank and congratulate the Honorable Minister for bringing a legislation of this kind. And yesterday, the Honorable Chairman was mentioning about the evolution of Rajya Sabha, as to how we have evolved as an institution, legislating on subjects which are so important, so contemporary, so crucial for the development of society as a whole. Normally, the society reposes faith in the government and hopes that the laws will be made in such a way that will make the life better and easier. And therefore, a shining example of that evolution would be the piece of this legislation, wherein we are trying to address an emerging issue, a problem that people face in their family life, and in a manner that is really progressive and taking the society to a new level of evolution. So I must congratulate you. Thank you for bringing this legislation. Sir, this is very sad commentary that a country of one point, maybe when I'm giving the number, I may be wrong, and I don't want to be hauled up for giving wrong numbers, but our population may be anywhere between 1.37 to 1.38, and by the time I'm speaking, it might increase even more. But this size of population, despite having so many people, probably the largest, most populated country in the world, overtaking China, maybe marginally, still there is a problem that some women, some mothers, despite being aspiring mothers, cannot become mothers. It's a very unfortunate thing. And therefore, surrogacy becomes one way of addressing that problem. And therefore, this is really necessary that we must work on it. And as is mentioned in the object for bringing this legislation, it is very clear that the object of the piece of this legislation is India has emerged as a surrogacy hub for couples from different countries for past few years. There have been reported incidents of unethical practices, exploitation of surrogate mothers, abandonment of children born out of surrogacy, and import of human embryos and gametes. And then therefore the Law Commission also worked on it. I would like to request the Minister that if the trigger for bringing this legislation was obviously this phenomena in which foreigners are trying to exploit vulnerabilities of Indian society, wherein poor women could be exploited by giving some money and then trying to make them surrogate mothers. But it looks like that some of the provisions of this legislation or the proposed bill, or this bill, the proposed law, is not necessarily only confining itself to this issue. It is also intruding in some of the local challenges that people may be facing domestically within the country, and therefore I request the Minister to please look at it. For example, we are saying that both mother and both the couple, they should be Indian citizens. It is also possible that an Indian mother or a foreign mother married to an Indian, they could be having a situation like this. If they are residing in India, there is a possibility that somebody may not have opted for a citizenship in India. They may not have relinquished their citizenship in other country and trying to be there. Why should we restrict it to that level? So this is something which is not addressing the problem for which the object, for which the bill is trying to be made. If they are willing, they are genuine, their citizenship alone should not be the reason for depriving them of this right of surrogacy. So I think that should be looked into. The second issue is surrogate can be only once we can do it. Again, just imagine, and only a woman can say this, there are many who are saying that one child is preferred But there may be couples who may be interested to have more than one. And since it is already accepted fact that that couple cannot have, that mother cannot have a child, that's why they are going in for surrogacy. Obviously, the other child also, they will have to go in for the surrogacy. Why should you only restrict it to one child? And therefore, I think that again seems to be not a restriction, not a intended purpose for the legislation. So I think we should really try to look at it properly. I just read the bill and making some comments, so you can correct me. I just saw the bill and I'm trying to read it just now. Also, surrogate mother, and that can be done only through close relative. I was just reading the definition clause. There is no mention of who is close relative. The clause 3 does not mention, clause 2 does not mention that what is close relative. So it again will subject to unnecessary issues. So I think this again, the purpose for which the legislation is made and the prescribed provisions in the bill do not necessarily work in tandem. And therefore, we should try to look at it like this. Of course, there are some very good ideas which I fully support. One of that is that surrogate child rights. This is very important because if the child is born out of that process and it is going to be abandoned, it will be really, it will be the most inhuman act that one could commit. And therefore, we must not allow that to happen. Therefore, I really definitely support it. And second issue, again, I still do not know why, that we are saying the age limit, 20 to 50. In fact, where in India, the life expectancy is on the rise. We are seeing now people living, even right now, for an old man like me, I can claim to be young, because the life expectancy is rising. And therefore, in such a situation, to putting restriction only related to age may not necessarily be right. Again, the same things apply about 5 years after marriage. Just imagine, if doctors can certify, or an honorable minister, a very distinguished doctor, a very dear friend of mine, I've got a great regard and respect for him, and we share a very close relationship. So that now close relationship is not defined. What is close relationship? Anyway, close relative. So I was saying, if it is known, maybe in the few months of the marriage, why they should wait for 5 years? Why they cannot have a child early? This is something which we should really think about, so that they can give more attention to the child and can really look after the child better. And the reason for which they are going in for surrogacy, they can also be satisfied because they can enjoy the life better. So I think this again should be really looked into. I feel that surrogate clinic registration is a very good thing. Can we think about, because you are making such a modern legislation, I am thinking about why not make this registration online or something like this, wherein you don't have to bring again inspector back into the clinic, but do it in something, because you are making such a modern piece of legislation. And therefore, why not think about even modern practices as to how the registration can be made. In fact, our chairman of a standing committee of health, of which I am lucky to have a member, he always keeps about talking modernity into legislation. Therefore, I think we can make a beginning in that by doing something like this will be a very good idea. I think we really need to work on it in a different way. The age I talked about, surrogacy I talked about. So I think I really look forward to this legislation setting an example of addressing contemporary issues with modern outlook, at the same time ensuring that we protect the citizens' right but do not necessarily intrude on them in a manner that the personal choice of a family, of a couple, should not be decided as to in what manner it will be exercised by the state. So I really support the bill. I really look forward to Honorable Minister taking these forward steps. In fact, I must commend him because he has been bringing a lot of legislation of late and trying to do that. So in a way, he is actually doing a surgical strike on bias through a surgical tools to make sure that so many problems of ailment in medical care are addressed. So medical is to address the ailment. But what about the ailments in the medical care itself? And that's what you are trying to address. I must congratulate you. I look forward to working with you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.